guys, I'm really stressed about this speech. In general, have any of you done a group presentation before? Or
I haven't done one.
I haven't done one either, but I'm sure we'll figure it out.
I mean, all of us can benefit from at least learning how to give a group speech. We kind of need to group together and be successful to actually pass this class.
Unless one person wants to take over and do all the work.
But that would never happen, right?
I mean, is anybody in this group qualified enough to even start this project?
We know what we're doing. We've done some research. We're totally qualified.
Didn't spend the last half hour together, so I think that's sufficient enough, don't you?
Yes.
I mean, these group presentations, they can seem kind of intimidating at first, but they're actually pretty easy to perform as long as we work together and actually come together cumulatively.
All right, well, let's get started then.
Well, like you said, group presentations don't have to be so hard. We can just break it down parts, like
icebreakers maybe, and getting to know each other first before we start working together.
Okay. And we should probably define what a group speech is. Where to start?
We have to divide up the work. I'm not doing it all.
And we also have to, at least before we divide it up, figure out who's good at what.
Okay, yeah, so that sounds great and all, but in reality, one of us is just going to do all the work, right? I mean, come on guys, I hate group presentations. I don't even, like, why are we even doing one?
Well, when I talked to Larson on April 25th, when I did that little interview thing, she said that when discussing group presentations, I love them. So I think that means she'll give us a better grade, right? I mean, it can't hurt that the teacher likes what we're doing. I guess, yeah, icebreakers and getting to know each other would be a good way. And according to this article that I found, accessed May 2nd, I believe, last week when we were working on it, according to teachpsych.org, many instructors are concerned with creating a community in the classroom. And icebreakers are better if they have relevance to a specific class. The best icebreakers are important, relevant activities that act as an additional feature and opportunity for the group to get acquainted. And I think getting to know one another in small, casual ways can keep help us ease any tension between us and get over that awkward phase so we can start working. I mean, don't you? I mean, people generally click better once they don't feel like strangers anymore. And not saying, you know, students in a classroom won't start out as strangers, but there still can be some barriers between people before they start to communicate with one another.
Okay, so my name is Hannah, and my favorite color is forest green.
Oh, my name is Sarah, and my favorite color is also forest green.
Are you serious?
Yes.
You can't have the same favorite color.
Yeah, no, okay.
Sorry.
My name is Ren, and my favorite color is pink.
My favorite color is pink, too.
My name is Trevor, and mine is seafoam green.
It's very specific.
So I'm so glad I now know everyone's name and their favorite color. But shouldn't we first define what a group presentation even is? Yeah, so Sarah, since you guys have never been in a group speech before, if you want the literal textbook definition, I did find one in that book we all bought at the beginning. Know that one written by the ECC professors.
Sorry.
Here, communicating with others, a guide to effective speaking in a complex world. Believe it or not, it's actually pretty helpful. And anyways, I found a quote today, and it's on page 194. So if you bear with me, it seemed pretty helpful. So it defines group speeches. We can define a group as a collection of three or more people who have some goal in common. Sounds like us.
Probably.
And, well, we all know that a presentation is just presenting something to an audience. So if we put those two definitions together, it's basically multiple people showing something to an audience together. And Ms. Larson wants us to write, to present it in either an informative or persuasive style. So our goal here is to write a bomb speech. And my vote is that we do it informative. I think it'll be easier, and though it is important in group speeches to know your audience. And in our case, it's just a bunch of college students, so we should present something that relates or applies to them.
I think it will be.
Yeah, probably.
All right, I'm gonna be really, really with you guys. In my opinion, and from my experience, group speeches are the perfect setup for slackers. I found this meme the other day. It says, when I die, I want the people I did group projects with to lower me into my grave. So they didn't let me down. Next time.
Okay.
relatable.
Yeah. So good.
Well, it is pretty funny and all, but it's not entirely true as long as we do try and work together and do our right work and divide it fairly.
Okay, I was looking at this article from the University of Mary Washington on, like,